The concept of terrarium originally was that you have a container which is closed from top and you have a lot of plants growing in. It's an ecosystem in a closed space. But recently, the concept of terrarium, I think, has evolved into more like a decor product, something, a decor item, something which is pretty and looks nice kept in some part of your house. So I haven't done a terrarium video, I think, over 2 years now. But when I started the channel, terrarium was the first thing I did. So I'm really excited but also slightly nervous that I haven't done it for a very long time. So I just collected whatever we had around the house. And so I have some succulents. Now I want to clarify a couple of things before we move on doing this. Why succulents? Because they're easy to maintain. I know a lot of people face a lot of problem with succulents, but go with cactus, so they don't require a lot of water. And something to decorate. So I have pebbles here, some crushed pebbles, which is like sand. I'll explain why not sand here. So let's begin. So I'm using these glass containers. You can use a fish bowl as well, and anything is fine. Now the thing is that we don't have drainage, right? That means there's no hole at the bottom, so the plant might start rotting. First thing we do is add a layer of charcoal. So this is horticulture grade charcoal, but you can get charcoal from the local laundry press wala as well. It's the same thing. Now, if you may ask that why charcoal? Charcoal has the property of absorbing, it's an adsorbent. So what it will essentially do is keep this system fresh. So whenever there's extra moisture, first we'll try and add not too much of water. But whenever there's extra moisture, it can absorb. And it's grainy in size. So that's going to be our first layer. The next layer is soil. Now, you can use any kind of soil. The only thing you have to keep in mind is that it shouldn't be a kind of soil that holds water for long. And just to add a layer, I'm adding pebbles. I'm not adding pebbles in the center because I'm adding them just for decoration so that we see some layers. Now I'm going to add more soil. So for general styling anything, there's this rule. I'm not an interior decorator, but I've learned that there's this rule of three things. When you place three things together, they sort of look complete. I might not be using the best of words to explain what I mean, but I'll show you. So we're going to place them in such a way that we have three plants in three different sizes here. So I'm not using gloves. You can use gloves, but I know these cactuses are the ones that would not hurt and the thorns are not at an angle that will hurt my fingers, but I would recommend using gloves. You can loosen the soil from the pot as well, because the roots will establish themselves in the new soil. And now I'm just going to add more soil around it. I'm trying to keep this as basic and simple possible. People do a lot of other things as well, but I want you guys to try this at home. It looks really pretty, and when people come in, they'll be like, oh wow, this is something different. So I don't want to use a lot of instruments. You can use, there are a lot of small tools for terrariums as well, you can. But I think this is like absolute basic things that you need. Now I'm using a spoon, you can use a metal spoon, any spoon, just to make the soil a little compact so that your plant stands. So the main thing for a terrarium is watering. And we have added charcoal and we are going to keep a good control on our hands for watering, which means that I'm going to water this probably once in 3 weeks. Yes, they'll survive. Don't worry, they will survive. In fact, more watering will kill them. Also, one thing, when you add soil, maintaining a level, a flat level is important, because if you don't and there's a bend on one side like here, So all the water whenever you add is going to collect here. So the roots here are going to start rotting and these plants will not get enough water. So only one thing I recommend, everything is very simple, but one thing I recommend is maintain a level. And now I'm using a brush to clean this up. If you don't have a paintbrush, you can use a toothbrush as well. But it's just convenient with a paintbrush. Okay, so our skeleton is done and now it's all about your creativity, how you can make it creative. So I honestly didn't have anything in the house. I just had some crushed stones. So a lot of people suggest sand. You would see a lot of YouTube channels suggesting sand. I face a problem with sand is that sand is very fine. So if you pour sand on the top of it, when you add water, the sand is going to eventually go down and mix with the soil. So that's going to be difficult. So instead, I'm using these crushed polished stones that I think are available online as well. I will put links to everything I can find online so that if you want to check them out. So most of temperate countries, temperate is a kind of a climate. So most of temperate countries like US, Canada, their succulents do really well for most of the year. But in India, which is a tropical country, a little geography because we are very close to equator, the sun is intense. I've realized that succulents don't do really well in summers. So if you want to have succulents, because I know they are irresistible, I would say that winters are the best time. So from October, November till March is a good time for succulents. For cactus, cactus is also a kind of a succulent. They mostly do well across the entire year. So in India, I would say if you want to have succulents, cacti are a very good option. I think only adding these crushed pebbles has sort of made it look nicer. And now for accessorizing it, I don't know, probably I'll add some pebbles. You can also paint these pebbles if you want. And remember, I was talking about that rule of three. So somehow they feel complete to the eye. So I tried three different heights. I think I can put one more butterfly. I really had no idea what I'm going to do, but I think it's very calming to make a terrarium. I have been slightly under the weather and not feeling well, but I feel really happy making this terrarium. If you like such fun ideas, do let me know. We can do more such decor, DIY projects, and do try it. Even if you don't have this, you can try with a mason jar, those glass bottles that we have for achar and everything. You can put one plant in it, decorate it and keep it. So now for the maintenance of it, for watering, we'll try and use a syringe and try and target the root ball directly instead of watering the entire thing. And because it's a cactus, it doesn't require a lot of water. I'm going to do that once in 3 weeks or so. And I'm going to use a 30 ml syringe. I actually learned it from YouTube and it works really well. And the second thing, will the decoration be affected by watering? Not so much, because we have very simple layers. My pebbles are actually hiding now. So I think you can skip the pebbles. Because of course the soil is fine and will go down. So we just have 2 layers, soil and crushed stones. If you want, you can add sand, but I feel the sand is too fine. It mixes with the soil, it gets difficult. For accessories, you can do anything. Now, where do you keep it? I keep it next to a window. So our house is west facing. It's mostly brightly lit during the day. So we get direct sun as well near this window. And if you want, you can keep it outdoors as well. Try and avoid afternoon sun, especially if it's west facing, because it's too intense. But if it's east facing, direct sun is also okay. I hope I've answered all questions related to a succulent terrarium, but if you have more questions, let me know down below. Thank you so much for watching. Before you move on to the next video, I have something really important to say. I love sharing whatever I know about plants with you. Indoor gardening, kitchen gardening. And day by day, as the channel is growing, I get a lot of questions on plant care, on plant maintenance. As much as I try to answer each and every question, sometimes it gets difficult to answer all of them. For this reason, I'm thinking of starting a step-by-step online course for gardening so that you can create your own little sanctuary, your own kitchen garden. But I want to know that would you be interested in something like that? All that I need from you is to fill out a survey. It's just going to take 2 minutes of your time, and a link is going to be down below in the description box. It'll help me to build something important for you. Thank you so much in advance. It'll really, really mean a lot to me. Thanks for watching.